to another Friday's lesson. So as promised from my timetable, today we're going to be looking at making friendship bracelets together. This is a really simple thing for you to do at home, and you can get quite creative with it really. You can use loads of different colours, or if you look on the internet there are different patterns that you can do for a friendship bracelet. The one that we're going to do today is quite simple to use, but it looks really good. Now you might want to give this friendship bracelet to one of your friends, you might want to give it to somebody in your family, that's totally up to you, or you might want to keep it and wear it yourself. So for this video you will need some string. You will need preferably two different colours, if you can find two different colours at home. Now my string is quite thick, so make sure that your string isn't too thin, otherwise it might snap quite easily. You will also need some sellotape, or just any tape, it doesn't really matter. And you will also need some scissors. You might need an adult to help you to cut the string, but after that you should be absolutely fine on your own to just follow this video with me. So we're going to start off by getting our two pieces of string just next to each other like I have done here. You will then need to put the ends of the string and line them up just like that. Okay, once you've lined them up, hold them in between your finger, and then you need to measure down to your elbow. Make sure that when you're measuring, that you're keeping your hand upright. Don't do this, otherwise the string will be too short. Keep your hand up and measure down to your elbow. Then pinch the string where your elbow was, and then you need to get the scissors and just snip. There. Okay, so you should have a piece of string, or two pieces of string, that are the length of your forearm, which is this bit here. Okay, you've got those two bits there. Now pop those two bits to the side, but keep them together because that is going to be your skeleton in just a minute. So for the next bit, which is going to be, we called them our tentacles when we did this in school, so the bits that we're going to be wrapping around, you need to make sure that these bits are a lot longer than your skeleton. So what we did, well, we actually measured the table at school, but your tables at home will be a little bit different. So for this, you're going to do the same again. Measure down to your elbow, pinch the string, and this time we're going to then bring it down and around so that it's double the length of our skeleton. And then once you've done that, where your string, the ends of your string line up with the other bits, you are going to just snip there, so that now you've got two longer bits of string as well. Okay, the next bit, you're going to get your skeleton here, so this bit's the shorter bit, and you're just going to tie a little knot at the top. Now you might need an adult to help you do this if you don't know how to tie a knot, but if you know how to tie a knot, and then pull it tight. Okay, then you need to get one color from your tentacles. So your tentacles are the longer pieces of string, so I'm going to get my white one first, and then where your knot is on your skeleton, you're going to tie your tentacle around like so. So just tying it, hopefully you can see that, around the knot so that that stays on there nice and firmly. Here we go. And then I'm going to get my pink tentacle, or my pink leg, whatever you want to call it. We call it a tentacle, it's out to the outside. And then we're going to do exactly the same, tying that one around the knot at the top of your skeleton. There we go. So you should now have one really long piece on your left hand side, and in the middle should be your skeleton. Now your skeleton is the bit that's got the shorter pieces of string, that's there, look. And then on the other side should be your other tentacle. So you should have one color on one side and the other color on the other side. Right, I am just going to move the camera down so that you can see what the next step is, and then we'll get started with making our bracelet. Okay, so like I said, you should have one long piece to one side and the other long piece to the other side, and then in the middle should be your two short pieces there. The next stage is to grab the sellotape. You'll just need a little bit of sellotape, so peel some off, cut off the scissors, and then you need to stick down where your knot is. This will help you when you are making it to stop it from moving around, because as you can probably already tell, it moves around an awful lot. So just stick that down to the table like so. Then you will also need to stick down the bottom of your skeleton as well. So these bits down here to stop them from moving. So pull them tight and then stick that down there. Right. Cool. Your bracelet should look something like mine right now. So your two long bits to the side and then your short skeleton in the middle. Okay, so for this we are going to start with our colour on our right hand side. You're going to tuck it underneath your skeleton and bring it back over, and then you should have a loop here. You're then going to take your end from your string and pop it back through the hoop, making sure you don't get the other tentacle, pulling it all the way up to the top. There we go. And then we should have, I'll just move the camera down, we should have a little loop like that. Okay, and then we do the same with the other side. So picking it up, putting it underneath, getting your loop, bringing it back over the top and underneath, and then pulling it very carefully all the way up to the top. Now it's important when we are doing this to be really, really careful with what we are doing. Don't pull the string too harshly, otherwise you'll just end up with lots of knots. So we go back over to the other side.